Hello children, how are you all? Welcome to Ablon Public School at home. So children, in last class I told you about the actions define people. In that I told you about SR7, Swami Vivekanand, SR8 and SR10. Okay children, now we are going to learn today SR 11, 12, 13 and 14. Before starting this children, let's learn some good manners. So you know very well children that teeth are a very important part of our body. Okay, with the help of teeth we can chew our food very well. And so teeth are very important in digestion of food. So we all should brush our teeth twice a day, in the morning and in the night before going to bed. Okay children, so make a habit to brush your teeth twice a day. Now let's come on our topic. Okay children, so open SR11 page number 16 of your ELGA 8 book. So Swami Vivekananda's real name was Narendranath Datta. What was his real name? Narendranath Datta. When he became a monk, he was given the name Swami Vivekananda. Okay, so what is the meaning of monk? A member of a religious group of men, that you can say saint also, sadhu. From his childhood, Swamiji was eager to see God face to face. He asked many religious stalwarts about his desire to see God, but none of them could satisfy him. Swami Vivekananda wanted to see the God, but you know children, nobody can see the God. Okay, it is only divine power that we can feel in ourself. In his journey to find God, he learned a lot. Swamiji's teacher taught him that God lives in every human being. So by serving humankind, he can serve God. Means God lies in our soul. So we all should take care to serve every humankind. Swamiji started traveling around India to share this with everyone. He spread the message of serving humankind and the God is one. Swamiji also established the Ramakrishna Mission. The purpose of this mission was to serve the poor and people in need. Means children, that we all should take care of everyone in this world without any selfishness, because everybody is the representative of God. God lies in our soul. Therefore, the mission didn't care about caste or religion. So, in this mission, there is no foundation of caste and religion. Swamiji was invited to participate in the Parliament of World Religion in the USA. In his lecture, Swami Vivekananda explained to the world that God is one, that is almighty, superpower, and he keep a watch on everyone in the world. Okay, children? Now come on, next page, number 17, SR 12. In this we are going to learn hard G and soft G. Okay children, so G when followed by A, O, U. Okay children, followed by A, O, U and then consonant. So it become hard G. It pronunciate G, like GUM, gum. BAG, bag. GOOD, good. GAME, game. DRAGON, dragon. GOL, goal. And what is soft G? When it fall, J, G is followed by EIY, then it become J, sound J, like GENTLE, gentle. DANGER, danger. APOLOGY, apology. GINGER, ginger. GEM, gem. GIRAFFE, giraffe. Okay, children. Now look downside words with soft G. GYM, gym. GENIUS, genius. Bridge, giant. Jewel, energy. Orange, fuse. So these are the words with hard G and soft G. Now open SR 13, page number 18. Okay, children. In this, we are going to learn Jim and Gotham. It is a story of these soft G and hard G words. So Jim and Gotham are brothers. Jim loves to eat oranges, but Gotham loves to eat grapes. Jim and Gotham go to a zoo. There they see a giraffe and a gorilla. The giraffe is tall and the gorilla is huge. Both of them are in cages. They both touch the giraffe and gorilla gently. After that, they wash their hands to avoid catching germs. Now, children, we all should wash our hands. They take a bridge to go back home. Now, I will tell you a story of Guinea likes oranges. So, Ginny is a happy girl. She goes to school and studies in grade 3. She has to cross a bridge to get there. Today, in school, they are learning about spices. The teacher shows them a picture of ginger. Ginny is very happy to see ginger. Ginger is her favorite spice. That day, while going home, a gentle breeze is blowing. Ginny sees a huge orange tree. She wants to pluck some oranges, but the tree is too tall. She wishes she were a giant so that she could get the oranges easily. Okay, children, this is the story of soft G and hard G. Now let's come on next page. It is a poem written by Sarojini Naidu. So let's learn about Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu was known as the Nightingale of India. It is very important question came in general knowledge that who is known as the Nightingale of India. So answer is Sarojini Naidu because of her poems. She was born and raised in Hyderabad. Through her poem in the bazaars of Hyderabad, Sarojini Naidu is trying to show the lively market of Hyderabad. In the poem, we can see conversations between customers and sellers. In the poem, she is asking questions to show different things that are sold in the market. So you can see here the picture of marketplace. What do you sell? Oh, ye merchants. Merchants means traders who sell goods. Richly your wares are displayed. Turbans of crimson and silver. Okay, now show me your goods. She is saying that show me your goods, whatever you have, like turbans in crimson and silver color. Tunics of purple brocade. Tunics of purple brocade. Brocade means a soft cloth stitched with a raised pattern using gold or silver thread, like lashes. Mirrors with panels of amber, daggers with handles of jet. So now show me turbans like that are shining like silver and that has a patches of purple lashes with mirrors. So what do you weigh? Oh ye vendors, saffron and lentil and rice. What do you grind? Oh ye maidens, sandalwood, henna and spice. So she went to next shop and she's asking, oh vendors, what are you doing? Saffron and lentil and rice. Do you have saffron and rice? So what do you grind? What are you doing here? Oh ye maidens, sandalwood. Do you grind sandalwood, henna or spice? What are you doing? What do you call? Oh ye paddlers, chessmen and ivory dice. So what do you make? Oh ye goldsmiths, wristlet and anklet and ring. So she is asking to goldsmith that what are you making? Bracelet or anklet or ring. Bells for the feet of blue pigeons. Or you are making bells for blue pigeons. Frail as a dragonfly's wing. Girdles of gold for the dancers. Or scabbards of gold for the king. So what are you making? A girdle means a belt tied around the waist and scabbard, a cover for a knife. Okay children, so this is the conversation between the customer and sellers. Okay, this poem is showing about the conversation of market. Okay, so Sarojini Naidu was in the favor of weavers also. Okay children, now revise this concept and we will meet soon in the next session of your ALGA class. Till then, be happy, enjoy your day and complete your work. Thank you.